Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Thanks for joining me, Raji's Quick Clips. Today we're talking about fat transfer. Why not just take fat and move it to the face instead of using fillers and biostimulators? Let's talk about that. Great question. So Raji's Quick Clips, I'm answering your questions from the comments. We'll get to yours. I got a big list, but a patient was gonna get fillers and instead thought, hey, I got a lot of fat. Why wouldn't I just take the fat, move it to where I want it in my face rather than pay for fillers? It's a great question. And there's different branded procedures out there that do just that. People take fat and they move them to the facial region and may or may not then use fillers and biostimulators after, but it gives them an opportunity to at least use some of their fat for their face. Why wouldn't I do that? Why don't most clinics do that? I thought it's a great question. Let's address it. Remember, click like if you like the video, click subscribe to become part of our family here. Helps us build this community. And don't forget, click the bell, because if you do that, you're gonna be reminded exactly when the new videos come forward and you can be among the first to watch them, keeping your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant. So fat, I don't use it for three main reasons. Number one, you have to harvest the fat. So when someone comes in, a lot of times they want something done, they wanna be in and out. You can grab a filler off a shelf and get a predictable result. If you do fat transfer, it's not a big deal. You put a little local in, a little tumescent, you take the fat out. You can add PRF to it or PRP. PRF is often a better choice as shown by the studies. Using rabbit models, but nonetheless, you add it because you want more to take. You want it to revascularize and live in the face. So you have to harvest it. A lot of people don't want that little procedure done. That procedure can also leave a little divot or scar because you've had to take fat from a part of the body, typically the abdomen, the lub handle, the back, and then you move it and you're depending on that fat to revascularize your lips. So that's why if you get a butt transfer, like fat transfer to the butt, a lot of times people can't sit on the buttock area for 6 weeks because that would compress the blood supply and the fat won't live. In the face, think about it, a buttock, if there's a little irregularity, if some of it dies, if it's not perfectly smooth, of course we don't want that, but it's more accepted in the buttock than the face. So imagine you're putting fat under the eye and let's say 80% of it lives, 20% doesn't. That 20% can create an irregularity. So you have to harvest it. The fat has to live, and some people are better with fat transfer than others, but you're depending on it to live, and if you're really good, maybe 80 to 90%, that's a high number, would live, so you can get irregularities. The temple might be an area or areas where you need a lot of fat moved. It's in the frame of the face. You wouldn't see it if it's a little irregular, and you can always add a bit of filler after fat transfer, so that might be a better use, in my opinion, than the face in the window where people see it. But here's the kicker. So you get it done, 80% of it takes. Let's just say you're one of the people that are happy with it. And you say, well, I kind of like it, 80% of it. I need the other areas touched up where it didn't quite take. What do you have to have done? If you're going to have fat and continue with fat, you're going to have to take fat again from an area and now potentially have another irregularity because in order to store fat, you need special certifications, sometimes tissue bank status to save body tissue. So it's not an easy thing to store in your clinic to freeze fat to reuse. So oftentimes people harvest it again. And so now you have another procedure done just to touch it up. If you had a filler done and you need a little touch up, there was a little area you didn't like, you just grab filler and you add it again. Now, you're still going to want to have done your skin tightening radio frequency, high frequency ultrasound, microneedling, plasma glow, all those procedures. It just takes a part of the filler. So while fat can be good for some people with extreme volume loss, maybe areas of the temple, those are a few reasons why I choose not to use fat. Have you had it done? Do you like to use it? Join me here, subscribe, join me on Instagram, and again here for Raji's Quick Clips. More to come. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.